Hello and welcome to Team Fortress TV with Admirable, Kratos and John. We're here for the ETF2L Season 17 powered by TT Esports Premiership Week 1 fixture. It's Daughter versus Lego, Sweden versus Denmark. We're here for Granary and Gullywash, two maps and 6 points up for grabs here. Kratos, welcome to Team Fortress TV. Are you nervous?
Thank you. I'm pretty fine, I would say. Not that nervous.
But, you said you cast it before? With those blackout scrubs?
Yeah.
With John?
Division 1 game? I guess John was in there as well, yeah.
Okay.
I think
I'm going to put you through your paces today. I'm going to talk all over you and just talk and talk for hours at length, you know. You need to be brave to cast me, man. You got to just tell me to shut the hell up when I'm rambling on. If you see something happening, I'm looking for you to jump in there. I know you Germans, you don't really like fun, but hopefully you can be less of a robot than most of your countrymen. Can you handle that?
I think I can handle it, yeah. Fuck the Germans.
Oh, shots fired. These are two Premiership teams, of course, as I mentioned. We saw them playing in the recent TFTV Zowie Invitational number 2. Lego were seeded like 7th, but they ended up finishing 4th. Surprised a lot of people, so they're probably the people's favourites. I would ask John, can we go to the straw poll before we get things underway and see how people are voting right now for... we've got 4 options. We're going to give you a chance to vote for each team and whether you think it could be a golden cap. We want to see how you're feeling about this map. Who's going to take Granary? We've seen Lego play it pretty convincingly during that cup. Didn't see any of the daughter games except for the first one on Viaduct.
I guess the PCWs around that got, to be fair, without any disrespect, but they didn't play that well that I expected them to be. They lost many PCWs against lower teams, how I would rate them. That's really confusing.
Daughter or Lego?
And some of the playoff guys, like even the Lethal Weapon Russians, and I guess some other, I don't really remember, many of the playoff teams from this season, I would have expected them to be on the top 3 as well.
Yeah, it seems like everybody can beat everybody.
Yeah, actually, you saw it in the Zoe Cup, it was quite interesting. MLM, the Mailamu guys were 2nd place, and they just lost against Evocate in the ETF2L season now.
Yeah, they seem to be having some troubles. But another team that's been having troubles was, of course, Daughter, who started off with that sick roster on paper. You know, you got Zebesai there, he's been soldier of the season. He's had great success with Broder, TCM, Two Nuts as well, played and infused in recent seasons.
Yeah.
Then you got legend of the game like Rib, won so many titles with Dignitas, Walters, a household name, Beavern as well, the guy who was so good he got banned, and Nutson, they also played around the Division 1 level before going to Tribes of Sen, but these guys haven't found the chemistry, and recently they've changed up from playing Zebesai on Roamer to Zebesai on Pocket, and apparently the results have started to slowly change. They've been doing a little better in practice. They said they didn't care about leading up to the Zowie Cup, but now apparently they do. So really, they're coming into this game thinking that they're the better team and that they should be beating Lego. This is probably a team they've said in their mind, along with Fenix, that they can beat or should be getting a win against. And they're going to play Fenix tomorrow as well, so tune into that tomorrow, guys. But this is probably a must-win here for Daughter if they want to get any confidence back in their game. But at the same time, Lego are this totally unknown quantity in the Premiership. It's their first season here, and they don't play that much or that many practice games against the top teams, from what I've been seeing. I've been asking the teams, and a lot of people are unsure about Lego, but they showed they can produce the goods. They can play a solid game of TF2 in the cup, and I'm not sure who's gonna win.
Yeah, they surprised us a lot as well in last Division 1 season. I wouldn't expect them to win this last season. For example, I also MIPC, but that's not who's playing tonight.
I can see the poll results right now. Lego are currently ahead by 4 votes. They've got 58% of the vote for Lego to win this in a straight win. 48% of the vote, sorry, Daughter on 38% of the vote. Six people think it's going to go to a golden cat, but it's tied up at 7% apiece. So even the audience aren't that sure. Looks like we're going to go live, though. And if you have just joined us, this is Team Fortress TV's coverage of the ETF2L Season 17, powered by TT Esports Premiership Week 1 fixture, Daughter versus LEGO. And we're going to go to the first middle, Kratos. Tell me, what do you see here?
Yeah, so Rip is the lower left rollout, and I can't see Phil yet. He's really slow to med, he's lower left, is just arriving with his medic as well. He's trying some crazy jumps and jumping all the way onto their medkit and just dying instantly. That's really weird. Like, there's some follow up from the squads. I managed to get one soldier, but they also, well, they can't really do anything. Yeah. That is a way better position there on middle.
Oh, look at that! Everybody's looking up at the soldier. Hellberg comes in and gets two nuts, aka two mics. And it's somehow, there's Zen as well following up after Hellberg, gets Zebesai and Beavern. And the scouts of LEGO doing a bit of work there. Walter's managed to pick up two frags in that middle as well. He got the bomb in Phil, but it seemed to be a ploy from LEGO. You know, they were going to send in their demo man to try and do some damage, then send in their soldiers to try and do some damage.
That was a really interesting
tactic. I mean, that's the Kratos jump, I would call that one, where you just get a buff in the corner, but Phil didn't seem to get much height. I think he could have jumped much higher and done a lot more damage from the air. But now...
F2 got forced here by Knudsen. That's really nice work. It's really important. So that's a 50% advantage for the Dotters, for the Swedish team. But let's see, they're holding Yard really close, and I'm sure they're gonna push on this. They will have six men up really soon again. Let's see if to see if LEGO's trying something here. It seems like they're just setting up for middle and group up there again.
Yeah, it's a bit of a leapfrog action going on here. They just traded their uber charge, their uber advantage for control of the middle point. Now it's on to Daughter to try and do the same. They're gonna come in high here. Two nuts eats a little spam. He's down to 60. He's dodging rockets. And he's getting pistoled a little bit, drops down for the kit, and he's back to full health. So he's managed to make it all the way into middle without popping off his uber. And that's not easy to do as a medic, so we salute you, Max Urdit. But, oh, they're going to continue with the push here. Look at this Zebesai. He sees red players in front of him, goes in, gets the frag onto Krizzle there. Meanwhile, and Beavern killed Natural earlier. And he's just respawned, but this is a man vantage situation here right now for Daughter as the Swedes push forward.
Rip, yeah, some nice damage of Rip here. Oh, they need to get Phil as well, and LEGO have to walk all the way back, see if F2 can survive this. It's already really far out. Like, you can see LEGO is playing so passive, so defensive. It's really, really nice play that F2 has managed to get out there.
Yeah, he's a smart guy. I think he saw that the writing was on the wall. And we're seeing a sort of a different style here from Daughter than we might have seen in the preseason. I mean, Zebesai is a player who loves to play super aggressive. We saw when he played Scout last season and previously whenever he pocketed for Broder. But he still plays aggressively on pocket, but it just means that Two Nuts has to follow him into all these crazy situations. He gets all the heals, but he puts out a lot of damage. And hopefully his team can follow up. Now here comes the Uber from Broder, or from Daughter up top, though. They've traded Ubers. And it looks like they're going to escape through that top side. The Ubers have been traded. Now it's time for the repush, but Walters has already gone down. And if you're just going in for an Uber trade, you really can't be losing people on the flank like that. Maybe Walters is going to off-class here, but I don't think Daughter are going to continue to push until he's back on the field, at least.
Yeah, they're already out on CP2. They're running a heavy, by the way. Let's see if we mention it. And yeah, Walters on sniper. So let's see. It's Hellberg against Walters. Hellberg sniping the left gate. Almost hit the shot there on Knudsen, it was, I guess.
I'm watching the Walters cam right now. He's coming over to the right hand side. He gets the headshot onto Hellberg. Had to jump on him. And I'm sure we're going to see a dry push here. But F2 actually has a little bit of an uber advantage. So supposing Daughter came in without their charge, Two Nuts might die here to an ubered natural. He's actually half health right now. He's taking a little bit of fire. Oh, look at this. Ubers comes in. F2 pops immediately to counter. Hellberg has just respawned. And. The Uber's better here for LEGO. They're going to try and continue, but they don't get Two Nuts. He's super weak, 30 HP stuck in the corner there. He's forced back into the garage, and the rest of his team are unable to get in.
Scott just finished him. So it's B1 inside the D. He's just moving back. Let's see if Rip can escape. He's really weak in the garage side. I guess he will be able to walk out. So we see B1 and drop down. See if he's going to be the ninja heavy or just going back and fallback. Yeah, he's hiding in drop down right now.
I don't think that's a good hiding spot. I can definitely see his gun sticking out there. Yeah, switched up to the shorty.
Searching him already.
You must have spotted him there. You can see his shoulder. What the hell? But you can't really challenge him, can he? They can set up a trap, maybe. They could like get four guys waiting below the drop down.
Yeah, he just went back.
Advantage situation right here for F2. I'm sure he knows that he's got 50% on two nuts. They see Demo Man watching that Rumbrim area, so they gotta expect the sticky traps. That's encouraging them to move left. There's a heavy up top. That is gonna be hard to push against Phil and Natural. Actually, Forged here, catching a lot of spam there, combined from the heavy. The Uber comes in, and Lego's push onto middle was not as impressive as that previous one we saw from Two Nuts. They're gonna just trade Dutson for Krizzle there and then back out. I think that is definitely the smart move. Maybe not the most exciting to watch, but they realized they were at a disadvantage there. F2, a mastermind of the game, he knows when it's time to back out.
So again, that's a big advantage for them, like 60% almost, 50%. And they're pushing the yard, getting the yard for free. Let's see, Lego again really passive here, already holding on second point there. So Dodge just moving into garage. So they probably can't block the second anymore, but they will have the Uber in time for the last point. So the Uber.
So there's a Lego up top there. Krizzle always already killed Beaver on the flank, but Natural and him trying to do focus spam onto the point. And they've cleaned up everybody. There's Zen finding Rib behind, so there's no threat of a back cap. I can see with my hacks outlines plug-in that all the blue players are in front. Three of them are up right now, and you see Beaver building furiously with his Boston Basher. Not even cool enough to have the three rune blade. Step up your scout game, Beaver. What the hell?
So yeah, but again, you could see Lego is really, really passive play. So even with the Uber disadvantage, or they just get paused now. Well, like on second point, even with the Uber disadvantage, they managed to get back and just repush this with an Uber advantage again. Now he just got popped there by Knutson, that's really nice work, and that's an Uber advantage for the Swedes again, and they are already moving the way forward. They're pushing through Catwalk, it seems, with a Soldier and Scout and Medic. Devil's Eye is already in.
This is actually, it seems like F2 wants to play it very safe. He's not going to make any plays and back off there, but, I mean, if you actually have a player pick there, that's not a bad situation where you could try for a wraparound play if you wanted to be risky. You could let them push you from the ramp room, Uber in there, and just go right, go behind them. Because it's, you know, there's going to be fewer players on the flanks. They killed the roamer, so they could have tried to take that gamble, but they didn't. They're going to go back here, and they've not managed to get two nuts to pop his Uber yet. Hellbrug and Zebo are both down, though. Zebo, the pocket here, the guy who would have been calling this call is dead, or calling this push is dead. So it looks like it's going to be up to Two Nuts to make a little play with his scouts here into the garage. They're going to bring in Knutson as well. They're really trying to focus down these garage players. And this is a dangerous play here from Lego. It's something you don't see that often. A lot of teams are more than happy to just sacrifice the garage these days. Look, Walters chases down Krizzle, but Hellberg finishes him off. But like, yeah, if you watch like Made in Germany play, they don't keep players in the garage anymore. Like, a lot of these teams, they just give up the garage because it's, it's sort of like an obvious place to find picks. But Lego had two players there and they lost two in the end up, but they did manage to get frags in the process, so they didn't really lose much on the back of that, but something to consider anyway. Looks like Daughter are going to try and take control of the high ground, though. They have got lots of blue players here in the garage, and Nacho wants to challenge
really
him
nice
directly. Gets Knutson. Oh, F2 drops him, he's not paying attention there. But they did get the force off. This is a strange situation right here, Kratos.
Yeah, Rip is on 10 HP, just we're all the way chased inside the yard. So he's on 50 HP again, maybe he's coming back in on second point from the right now. He's pretty much alone against the scout. He's playing it really safe, just spamming some pipes. Some stickies actually, and getting the frag on Zen now. It was really well played. I don't know if you saw Rip playing there. He got chased down by a scout and was low to 10 HP, but still managed to push this and get one frag even. It was really well played.
Are you a Rib fanboy? Do you want to confess something?
not in the public.
Which is a really nice rib guy. Shrine in your house, yeah. Little lock of his beard hair.
Like, seriously, he's there for ages. Where I started to play TF2, he was already in the Prem, or in the Defron, it was, like in season 6.
Here comes a push. Lego, we're gonna Uber in from the top. Natural wants some Swedish blood. He's going in deep here. There's stickies everywhere. He's gonna get juggled around, rocket stickies, and now as the Uber fades, he's been isolated by the Dota team. He goes in deep onto two nuts, lands one rocket, but only really takes 50 health off him there. And now Uber advantage is firmly in favor of Sweden here, but with Walters down, it's a 5-on-5 fight. Natural is going to respawn around the same time. Here comes the Uber from Zebo. How deep is he going to go here? Two Nuts is right behind him. He's got a scout with him as well. Looks like they really want to commit to this. They are hunting down these Danish players here. They focus down one, now two. But Zebo's gone down. Two Nuts is in deep. And his flank players are going to have to come in here without heals. Let's see if they can produce the goods. Rib is trying to pump out damage, but F2 is able to heal his players, whereas Two Nuts is not. And I think the heals just held out there.
Yeah, really well escaped again from F2, saving the Uber now and ending up with an advantage. Like, he almost died there as well. I guess he dropped down to 40 HP or something. So that's really important that he survives there. Now that's the time for Lego to push up again. They can get some frags there in Ram, maybe. The Uber straight into them, people.
Oh! He's gone down. He just was slightly behind the rest of his team. Nobody covered his escape there. He took a sticky and then another one. Phil just went straight in for him. Got that medic pick, and we might actually see Lego getting a little aggressive now that they have a significant man advantage. They're going to cap middle, but they like to play at a fairly slow and predictable pace. But they're just happy to cap middle. They're not going to stream ahead into the yard, try and get any more frags. They know the demo man's still up, so they have to be scared of red stickies, I think, Kratos.
Yeah, they should be scared. But still, they have an advantage, so they should probably use this. They're still building. So let's see, we're probably going to see another push there from Lego again. They have like a 30% advantage, and Dotters is really close. They're in yard, so they can maybe catch them in yard. Let's see what they're going to do. Seems like they want to push to the ramp room with Dr. Phil there. Or will they just wait and set up?
If you have just joined us, guys, this is Team Fortress TV with Admirable, Kratos, and John. We're watching Dotter versus Lego here in ETF2L Season 17, powered by TT Esports Premiership. It's a week one fixture. That means you're going to see Granary and Gullywash. Both teams have Ubercharge right now. They can both make themselves invulnerable for a maximum of 8 seconds. So we're going to see how these two teams of shiny red and blue players go at it. Oh, look at that double soldier aggression from Dotter, really clearing off the high ground there. Beaven comes in low, finds Natural, but goes down to Dr. Phil Sticky, and Zen kills Knutsen. And it seems that Dotter, the Swedes, have found themselves at a man disadvantage. They're sort of got players stuck in the corner here, but Zen side lands a couple of crucial rockets. Scout flank, though. There's a scout behind Zen has picked up Two Nuts.
Oh, F2's on his own now on the middle. F2's on his own and building the fight against Walters with a nice pistol here. So that's F2 down. Two Nuts got down as well. Not sure where he really died there.
Zen came in behind and killed him. Zen, like, I can see the live stats for this round. Courtesy of Ari, you know, Faculty Brigade legend. And Zen is currently ahead with 15 frags so far this round. He seems to have been there for the cleanup more often than not. Hellberg is right behind him, or he's the second in line anyway, on 10, Zebo on 9. So Hellberg and Zen, the Lego scouts are doing work here, comparatively speaking.
And both medics died, and F2 is on crits now, so they have their crits advantage. Let's see what they do with this. Seems they want to push from the right side with Dr. Phil. So let's see, Dr. Phil is going in, crits are used, it's a popped, managed to get Beaven and Zabodai, but Walters as well. Natural fits a nice rocket on Nuts in there. So it's two Nuts still alive with Rip there. It's two with the three, but they have the Uber. They're just holding the last, probably group up and then repush this.
I think Lego might go in suicide here for the Force. No, these Danes are like so
playing
passive.
So safe.
There's a window of opportunity there where you could easily sacrifice one, two players. Like, you've got nothing to lose. This is a really strong position here for the red team to just hold and defend CP2, even with a man disadvantage. But they decided to wait. And they've got a frag for their trouble, because here comes Zebesai pushing in with two nuts pops. There's a scout behind here, actually. They want to clean up Hellberg. I'm not entirely sure why he Ubered, but he
natural
did.
Natural on top with the crits now again.
Oh!
Demo's going down. Oh, two nuts going down as well. That's a nice crit. Really played. The heavy's going down as well. It's only scout alive. Waters probably can save the day for this time. So that's 1-0 for the Danish guys. For Lego.
Yeah,
really
was
smart move again with that crits move. They just went into garage and then just re-crits it from the top. That's really well played.
I wish I knew why two nuts popped his charge there, or because he didn't even Uber on Zebo. He like turned around to Uber somebody behind him. I think maybe they must have been close to death. But anyway, this is the second middle of the round. I'm watching Rib rolling in low, and Phil isn't even there yet. They're gonna do this buff and jump again. Phil jumps in high. He's putting out stickies on the soldier up top. And he's managed to survive longer in this middle, but he's going to get rushed down by Walters again, who killed him the first time. Meanwhile, Rib pipes Frizzle.
Yeah, Rib's coming in now with the heals. It's going to be shit.
Oh, there's a scout above as well. Walters onto F2. He's gone down to 40 former teammates here. It's Zebu who gets the frag, though, and Zebu picks up a 3k there on that middle. Not bad.
Yeah, that's a complete wipe for Dotters now, so they should be able to get the second point for free. Grizzle is on heavy, and Phil spawned as well, setting up some stickies on left. So they just set up from on the last. Phil is going down with some nice roamings from Debo there. He just flanked him from the top. So that's no demo for Lego, and no Uber either. So let's see, Debo there is on the heavy.
Nice heavy. Grizzle goes down, and there's a sniper on the field though, but everybody's still invulnerable. Hellberg is a bit of a beast, but he still can't kill Ubered players. And a quick response there from Dotter after that first 15-minute long round. That second one was less than 2 minutes, I think.
Yeah.
I want to really see nice what Dr. There. Phil is going to do in this middle. Like, he just
dived
in
for
the second
time.
Middle in a row. Oh, he's changing it up. Don't worry, guys. He is going to push lower right. And he's just spamming pipes towards the med pack. He's not committing in here. And now he starts to put stickies down where he thinks the combo's coming from, and he has separated two nuts slightly from the rest of the team. He's got them points up in the corner. In comes the bomb and soldiers from Denmark.
Some nice damage there. Well, Rip is stuck in the corner. He should be able to get down as well. Yeah, there we go. So it's 2-on-2 now. Devil's Eye is weak on 50 health. It's a 1-on-1 against Hellback. Oh, he managed to get Hellback. Wow. Just killed two players with 50 HP. That's really well played from Devil's Eye again.
Yeah, really, I liked what Phil was trying to do, what Lego were trying to do. Like, you just push down that right side, try to separate the combo or keep them in the corner, you know, and as soon as he saw they were there, he was able to call to the soldiers, and you saw that double bomb from Krizzle and Nigel. I think the fact that Zen died probably meant they lost middle, because he has been their carry so far. But Zebesai coming up with the goods there in that middle, and as the respawns come in, it seems Dotter will eventually take control of that. It's going to be equal Ubers here. Both medics running that normal metagun. No crits creep play here from F2 this time.
Yeah, so it's equal Ubers again. Oh, we have some nice hiding spot there by Krizzle. He's inside the right yard.
The force comes out again, and they haven't even got a frag for their trouble. Must have been a sticky trap that two nuts popped for. There's Zen going down to Walters, though. And Krizzle finally drops down from his perch to take out Zebesai. They know there's two players behind though, so I think Lego are going to try and turn around and get those easy frags behind. Both scouts are behind enemy lines here. They just need to buy time. And you see the Dotter combo moving forward here. Rib and Zebu know, or Rib, oh, that's nuts in there actually. They know that the scouts are behind and there could be a distraction, but it seems like they're not confident in this one. Maybe if it was Zebu, he would have been in there, but now the heavies of Dotter are going to back out. Knutson's going in for the bomb though. He lands a rocket onto Phil. Probably wanted to try and kill F2 there, but went for the Demo Man instead. He's been shut down. Natural will claim that frag. And now Lego find themselves with a man advantage in an equal Uber situation, but they're pushing still the player behind.
Yeah, but even still, we just got done now. So that's two players more again for Lego. So they're pushing now through the ramp room, through the top of the ramp room actually. Oh, Natural got down by a sticky trap of Rip. They have spawners already, so if they have to back out now, that's a disadvantage again for Lego. That's a really bad Uber. So they have to go all the way out. If they manage to survive, that's really important, so they can maybe hold the yard. Oh, they sneak behind to the right yard already. Oh, they lost their position there as well.
Oh, Krizzle goes in onto two knots, gets the medic pick. F2 is down to 70, but he's got players around him. He's got protection here. He should be able to survive this unless somebody makes a blunder. There's a sky from Z!
It's a crazy kill.
Krizzle
on F2.
Turns his back for a second, and Wallers comes just sneaking in there from that Z entrance, gets the pick onto F2, and that allows Daughter to save some face here in what was actually a wipe right there. A wipe.
The Swedes are trying to contest this. Krizzle with a nice rocket there on two knots. That's still got down there. So yeah, that's only three players alive for Lego now. With Phil, Helberg and F2. F2 is all the way back. Helberg is trying to get a frag or something there. Phil is trying to support him a bit. But as you can see again, F2 is really safe. He was back on the last, on the second point already, and Phil and Helberg were in alone pretty much. Yeah. They just want to save the Uber for the last point now, probably.
Even though those guys went in and died on middle against the spawns, they definitely bought a little bit of time here. And even despite F2 spawning later, he's probably going to have charge in time. Maybe not to defend. Oh, look at that! Dr. Phil gets the drop! And Zebesai unable to be Ubered there by two nuts. But Phil will go down for his trouble, but F2 has charge now, and it's just faded for two knots. Oh, the Uber comes in here and natural sort of whiffs the first jump, but gets in time. Lands one rock onto two knots, switches up to the shotgun, sends him to the spawn queue. And Phil is going in deep here. He's got support from Zen.
Oh, that's a late spawn for Rips. It's pretty bad for Team Dotters.
Oh, and Knutson tries to go in to get F2, but gets juked around a little bit. And the protection of F2 there by the scouts was excellent. And the scouts are able to follow up on the damage put down by natural as well. Great to see them playing around their medic, getting those heals. And Lego now find themselves in a commanding position here, having taken control of middle. They have a man advantage, and they are in the yard ready to start capping on CP2 here. Both scouts on the point. You do see the Daughter combo just holding there on that left hand side in their defensive perspective, trying to spam the point. But the Uber's coming up soon, and if they stay that close, they might get hunted down here by natural. And Zen. Oh, it's Helberg is actually going to join this one. Helberg and Phil are pushing deep.
Phil. Phil is going for the jump. He's focusing two knots. Not managed to get him. He's going down there. Helberg might go down as well. Yeah, he is going down. At least they got Rip and B1 down there, so they might try to continue there.
Yeah,
they are with Zen, they're natural.
They're trying to get that force onto two knots. Two knots just gets it now. Zebo knows it's coming. He's going to chase. Gets natural. Will he continue? He can see on his scoreboard now the spawns coming in for Lego. He jumps into a whole bunch of stickies there from Phil, who just expected Zebu to do what Zebu does and go forward, forward, forward. But he's gone down now, and Lego could push here if they want it. They have Uber,
and
they're probably going to wait
for
that.
The Uber now. Yeah.
But plenty of teams might just push on that man advantage, but Lego, they play it super safe. They're not going to take any risks. Rip with the sticky trap on natural, and already this Uber isn't really going too well. They're going to go in with Phil until he's unloaded, and then I might expect to see F2 back off a little bit.
Knutson on the very top pipe. That's a really nice position there from him.
F2 is looking for the door right now. They did get beavering throughout that Uber charge. That was the only frag. That's a couple of times, at least two in my memory, that Rib has managed to get natural before the Uber has come in there. Maybe FT wants to pop a little bit earlier. Here we see two knots going to lead with Zebo and Walters. He's flashed both of them. They're going to hunt down this Lego combo with Swedes all over Danes right now. But Helberg and Zen, again, with the great protection of F2 there. Of course, the damage of Phil helps a lot, but the scouts, they are really well drilled here. I'm impressed.
Yeah, again, the Uber advantage for Lego again. They're pushing it with the scout in the demo, it seems like. Helberg is going first. He's trying to get Rip. Doing some damage on. Oh, but they can't really chase it down. They just single Uber the scout in into a whole combo. I'm not sure if that was a really good idea. Like Helwig was against five players, even if he's Uber, he's not able to get anyone there.
Maybe he wants it
kind
to,
of a waste of the Uber.
You know, he's an AA, on-frame sniper, maybe he's gonna off-class. I don't know though, because with the Uber advantage for Daughter, you would expect him to push, not really a great situation to snipe, but it seems he will stay scout.
Yeah, he's
it's a pretty slow push here from Zebasa. He's being quite methodical, checking for stickies. They haven't popped off Uber yet. He's waiting until he can see F2, I guess, before he goes in deep. There's a soldier here on two nuts! Crizzle came from the garage that wasn't called.
Oh, two nuts with a drop, bro.
Oh, that's heartbreaking. He has just lost Uber advantage in the worst way possible. He's gone down, dropping the full charge. And I feel like it was a little bit of miscommunication because there was a scout pushing Crizzle out of the blue garage there, but... the blue garage, but two nuts didn't seem to be aware of that and took two rockets in his back.
Well, that's really bad for Dotters. Like, it's 4 minutes left on the clock. If Lego will get around now, and if they play it smart and will wait before they win the round, it's gonna be really hard for Dotters now.
Yeah, that's true. They can play the clock here. 4 minutes left. Here comes the charge, though. They just popped on natural. He hasn't been dropped this time, guys. And he's gonna go in. Oh, he's been stunned in the air, though. Dr. Phil's here to help him out, but took a lot of damage from that heavy weapons guy after that big insult jump. And look, the daughter cleaning up. But Zed takes a rib. That might slow things down a little. Crizzle's alive. He's trying to find if he can go up top for a back cap. He's going against 270 HP. Heavy though, so he thinks twice about that, goes back, and he's just a distraction right now up in that garage area, the lunchbox. And the scouts challenge him. Beaver and Walters are fearless here with their buffs. They will get the frag and manage to survive themselves, but Lego have already moved on to the point here, Kratos.
Yeah, they Ubered in now, Dotters, trying to chase him, but F2 again really, really far back, saving this Uber advantage of 40% now he has. So they will probably hold the yard even if they have two players down. It seems like they're staying close, trying to hold this and then push up with the Uber advantage then.
Oh, but they have blue players back now. They're all playing around their medic again, those heals moving forward. And they really want to kill F2 because he has the Uber advantage, and they need control. They need to start making a play if they want to actually get around on the board rather than go for the golden cap here. Maybe Daughter would be happy to take it to a golden cap.
Possibly. Like, after this map, they can be happy with it. Like, Lego was constantly pushing the last pretty much.
Oh, Zebasai's timed out.
Zebasai just timed out. Wow. That's really unlucky.
We didn't see a pause, though. Maybe he rejoins the server pretty quickly, but in this situation, with your pocket just lagging out like that, that's tough. Oh, and Knudsen gets a 2k up top, finds Helberg and Natural. But Natural did manage to kill Walters and maybe Beaver up there. Oh, now Zen is trying to go huge here. Crizzle's
only Zebulai and two nuts alive now. So this should be Lego's round. Let's see if Zebulai's going here with a big play.
Zebul jumps in, leaves his medic exposed. F2 runs onto the point, but Walters minces up Zen, F2, and Dr. Phil. Himself will go down, but his teammates respawning should surely be able to hold on to this point. 1 minute 30 left, and a big spawn wave coming in for the Danes in just about 1 second. They're going to be able to try and contest this point. Only Knutsen is up this far. He's going to jump back now. He sees the spawns coming in. He knows there's a soldier up top as well, and manages to deny Crizzle up there. But
seems like Dota's going to wait now and try to wait for the last push. Lego again on crits. This is gonna be interesting. They have 25% advantage with that crit. They're building it really fast. So it's all about Dr. Phil now. See what he will do. But they also have Waters on Sniper, so he could deny this. It's gonna be a really interesting push.
Yeah, I'd like to... I'm curious as to where they're gonna crits from. Looks like it's gonna be left.
Dr. Phil, they've
heard the sniper shot. Crits comes in. Oh. Shots fired. F2 gets headshot before Phil can even land enough shots there.
Yeah, he had time with three stickies, could only damage the heavy there, but two nuts managed to survive. Like, he dodged it really nice. So that's it, we're going to golden cap probably. Dodgers have got the Uber now to save it. Don't think Lego can push this, but they will of course try it. Let's see if something crazy happens.
Still 12 seconds left on the clock. It's unlikely they can kill an entire team of buff players and make it onto the point against an Uber charge in that time. And it seems like it could be a complete wipe here. Phil is going to pussy out. He will live to tell the tale. But yeah, that's going to be 1-1 after 30 minutes here in Europe. We play a golden cap system. You can't tie any map. So we're going to take this to another round of 10 minutes. If one team caps, they win the map. And they'll get 2 points for their trouble, but if neither team caps, the team which holds middle after the 10 minutes will take those 2 points. The losing team gets a commiseratory 1 point, which I don't understand. Why do you get 1 point for losing slowly? Come on, ETF2L. That isn't competitive at all. Yeah, soapbox.
Yeah, but still, it was an interesting game.
Do we have time to take a look at the logs? Of course, yeah. Of course.
So what's the logs?
You mean you don't have them yet? Me neither.
Let's see.
Someone will just post them in chat. Surely somebody will post them in Twitch chat. That's how I operate. There's always somebody slightly faster.
I got them.
Oh yeah. Tell me what you see. What's the big picture here?
Yeah, Zebul and I was the top damage. Like 10k damage. Almost 11k damage. So that's really interesting. Not Rip on top damage, it's Zebodai on top damage, a soldier. Also natural out damaged his demo, Dr. Phil.
He had 39% heals. About 1500 more than natural did. But that's
it's almost the same kills.
Yeah, yeah.
So you can see 98 kills for Legal, 96 for Dodgers. Oh, are we?
This is the golden cap of map 1 of this ETF2L Season 17 powered by TT Esports Premiership Week 1 fixture between Dodger and Lego. We're going to watch Phil and see if he is going to jump in and do something crazy on middle. Oh, he's gone ramp room this time. He's not going to do his aerial maneuvers this time.
Oh, some nice roaming on him already. Oh, he got forced back into the ramp room and now he can't come out again. But still, Tunats and the Roam are dead already. Let's see, F2 is going down as well from some nice shots to get from Walters.
Walters flanks all the way behind. Like, the whole of the Lego team were stacked in that right-hand side. Nobody was watching the flank after Krizzle went in and took care of Knutson. And Walters just walks behind. And I mean, that's something you have to be aware of. The whole Lego middle strategy was very defensive. They wanted to sit back. But somebody had to be watching behind there. Like,
Phil got instantly roamed there by Knutson. Even if he died, he forced him back to the ramp room, so Phil didn't have any position on the point at all. It was only Krizzle jumping in, getting the nice kill on Tunats. But at all, they didn't have any position. Then they got flanked and just got killed there in the ramp room.
Yeah, they were trying to play it safe. I guess they were hoping that Daughter would give them some free frags. Sat back, but I don't think they thought that one through. Anyway, Walters punished him, got that pick onto F2, but Tunats went down on that middle as well, and he is now building up his charge. It's going to be a neck and neck Uber battle here. We're going to see a little bit of a stalemate on last, and you know, Dodger have a lot of options here. They're winning right now. This is a winning position. After 8 minutes, they will win because they hold middle. They don't have to commit to a full push here. They could just go in with one or two guys
trying to push it. So both Ubers used. No single frag here. Walters is stuck behind them though. So they're moving in, going for the distraction. Let's see if Walters coming in now from behind. Yeah, he is going. He's going for F2. Got some damage on him, but not managed to get him. Just got one or two shots on him. So let's see. Red health for the sweets here. So Lego will probably push on this. I mean, they have to.
I don't know. I think they're going to wait. It's just the spawns are coming in and they have Uber advantage. Oh, they don't have Uber advantage. Phil did a great job of holding off that attempt at repush there by Dodger. The heavy walked in, but Phil just focused the doorway, kept the medic back, and actually got a pick onto Rib, which was definitely instrumental in holding it on there.
But Peppa gets on Cypher, getting Knutson down. Seems like Dodgers is still on top. they're a bit careful now since Havoc was aiming there. So we won't be able to get any more frags. He's back to scout now again.
Oh, look at this. Lego are taking the initiative. They're going to come in. And they trade Ubers, but it's not a good one. Two Nuts has milked his significantly. Zebo is just like, what are these guys doing? Drops natural, then Walters and Zebo combine to kill F2. And Lego were trying to take the initiative there, but really didn't research as to where exactly the daughter combo was. They went in, but look at the flank players. Phil goes huge. Picks up two frags, Zen and Krizzle as well, helping out there. And somebody dropped. Zebosai dropped again.
Zebosai dropped again, wow.
Little help there was from Zebosai's internet connection.
Really well played by Lego. They just out deathmatched them, the whole team actually, of Dotas, without the medic, without any heals. That was really nice focus fire there of Lego. And really well played by Dr. Phil as well. He just denied the door and got the 3k, I guess.
Yeah, I thought that was looking like a horrible situation for Lego, but they've managed to come back from last, take control of their own CP2, and they have uber advantage. Look at aggressive play of Daughter here. They're even committing their medic to this, and they could potentially be trapped here by the uber advantage of F2. There's a scout in on the flank! Again, pressure on F2, but he's managed to survive this time. He's about to get charged. He should know he has advantage, but they're running away just because Natural and Krizzle are down. Gonna come in with Demo Man and scout.
Popped off that charge. Phil is going to chase
him. Oh, might get two nuts. He gets him. Hilberg with the pistol onto two nuts. Gets another pistol whipping right there onto Rib. Both the Lego scouts are dropping pistol frags.
Knuts is behind them on F2, but F2 is already all the way back.
He showed himself Knutson a little bit early, or maybe a little bit late there when he came into the fight. He might have been wiser to help out his team a little earlier, but Lego coming up trumps there. I feel like that was overly aggressive from Daughter. Sure, they like to play aggressive, but in the face of an uber disadvantage and like committing yourself like that so far, it wasn't going to end well. And F2 being the sheriff here, he's punished them, man. He's got them locked up in the county jail, and they have control of middle, and they can literally just lock this down. They don't have to do anything. F2 might even want to park the bus here, you know what I mean?
Yeah, seems like it. It seems like they're doing exactly what you said, since they had the uber advantage, but F2 is all the way back again onto his catwalk. So they probably just gonna try to defend this.
Look at the position in here from F2 and Lego. They saw a couple of pushes from 2 to 3 executed by Daughter. One was that they came up top, and that's why they've got double soldier up there to spam that, and spam it they have. So once they could sort of read the mind of Daughter here, they've said, oh, we've denied them the ramp room, now they're going to come from the other side, and immediately the soldiers are here to deny that too. Oh! A direct rocket there will deny Knutson's jump. He's already in like 100 by the time he gets in on F2, but he doesn't have to get the force out. And a lot of players committing. Both medics have popped off here, but it's going to be lasting slightly longer for the Swedes. I'm looking to the scouts of Lego to try and do big work here. Follow up on the damage.
Oh,
that's
Zen on two nuts. Zen managed to get two nuts. And F2 again, all the way back, surviving, so that's an uber advantage. If they manage to get F2 out of this, they will be able to repush the middle again. With like a 70% advantage, so that's really much.
But think about this. So F2 and Lego push middle, and they uber to get middle. Still 3 minutes left on the clock. That's enough time for the leapfrog to happen. You know, Two Nuts is going to then have uber advantage, and Dodor are going to push into middle, and they're going to take control of it near the time whenever it's actually a winning cap. You know, like if they control middle in the dying seconds, they win. So if the F2 pushes right now, it mightn't be a good idea.
We will see. They're still trying to push this. Look, the Phil is jumping into their corner, gets some nice damage on the scout, getting a scout frag and soldier frag. So that's three players dead. They should be able
they
to
should continue,
keep moving.
They should
there.
Continue. They are. They're going to lead here. Natural gets just stunned in the air by the damage of Rib. They did get Rib for the trouble. And now if they can cap CP4, that uber advantage of two nuts won't be so powerful. That means they have to take back two control points to win. And Lego got a nice execution, and they've got a scout on last. It's Krizzle. He got the pain train roam play there, and the Swedes did not see that coming, neither did I. Wow.
that's really replayed. Like, I thought Dotters would maybe push out of this, but Krizzer just denied everything and just kept it. That's really nice. Really well paid.
Yeah, it was looking good for Lego anyway, having taken control of the middle and CP4, but he just went hit a home run there. And
yeah, some really nice chases there of Dr. Phil and Natural, actually. Dr. Phil did a lot of work in this golden cap.
It looks like Zebo's going to restart his PC as well. Maybe we should take a look at the logs from that golden cap. Have you got them?
Oh, yeah, let's check.
I'm going to get them. I'm going to get them. Oh, I'm faster than you, buddy.
Almost have them. Get them.
Yeah, there we go. The Krizzle top damaging. And also, Dr. Phil not far behind him. Who will we blame for this? Yeah, there's Beaver bottom damage.
Yeah.
Rib, two frags for four deaths. Didn't have a great time in that golden cap. He's bottom in terms of kills and assists per death. F2 actually, oh no, Knudsen's even below him as well. So yeah, we'll throw those guys under the bus. What were they thinking? It was a pretty long golden cap, went all the way to 7 minutes.
Yeah.